Few systems are as complex as the human eye. It's an orchestra of cells working together to sense and translate light, and the retina is the conductor. But there's a wide array of diseases that can affect the retina. Diseases like retinitis pigmentosa, a genetic condition that affects 1 in 4,000 Americans. So researchers like Dr. Val Canto-Soler and her team are developing ways to tackle retinal diseases.
Basically, we have found a way to generate what we like to call miniature human retinas in a laboratory dish. But very interestingly, they are capable of recreating the cellular organization of the retina. And even more excitingly, they are capable of sensing light the way the human retina does.
In short, they have discovered how to generate lab-grown retinal cells directly from a person affected by a retinal disease. They are extraordinarily similar to the human retinal cells, able to grow and respond to light in much the same way.
So that opens lots of possibilities in order to understanding much better the mechanisms that produce retinal diseases in people.
The work not only advances opportunities for vision-saving research, but may lead to technologies that restore vision in people with retinal diseases.
Are we using them for the experiment?
It also opens the door to tailoring medications to patients based on their individual chemistry.
You can actually start testing for the efficiency of action of an array of drugs in particular patients. And that may give you the ability to find the drugs that are going to work much better in a patient compared to others.
Dr. Canto-Soler hopes that one day retinal diseases will be easier to treat and cure.
We have the hope that the system that we have developed will contribute to eventually developing retinal transplants to regenerate the retina of a person that is losing the vision due to a retinal degenerative disease.
And as more light is shed on retinal research, the visionaries at Johns Hopkins continue to look at ways to help patients see, feel, and live better.